Now, money has no value by itself. It's just a piece of paper. Oh, really? Then why do people sometimes say, I want to have more money? Well, they don't actually want more money. They want the things that money can buy. They want cars, they want food, and they want cookies. And money is only precious for the things that you can buy. So it is natural that the demand of money depends on the real economy. And, well, it turns out it does. The demand of money depends on two things: transaction and assets. First, transaction cost. So in order to get money, you go to the ATM. And let's say there's only one ATM in the country you live in. Then it is very inconvenient for you to go to the ATM. The cost of one transaction of withdrawing is very high. So when you go to the ATM, you probably want to draw a lot of money at once. If, however, there are many, many ATMs around, then it is simply very, very convenient for you to collect money. Then the transaction cost of money is very low. Then you won't demand a huge amount of money at once. In fact, you probably keep very little money in your wallets, as we do in most modern countries, and have a very low demand for money. So if the transaction costs are high, there will be high money demand. If the transaction cost is low, there will be very low money demand. Now, let's assume that the transaction cost doesn't really change, because in reality, well, it doesn't really change. You don't suddenly have 1,000 ATMs popping out in the middle of an economy. Then money demand depends on the second thing, which is assets. So let's see, when you hold on to money in your pocket, is your money in the bank? No, it's not. It is in your pocket as cold, hard cash. You are not saving it in the bank, nor are you investing it anywhere else. Hence, you are losing the returns that you could have got by investing it or saving it, which is the interest rate that you could have got on these cash. Hence, if the interest rates increase, would you prefer holding onto the money or foregoing all the returns you can get? Or would you want to keep more money and invest it somewhere else? You'll probably want to not keep the money in your wallet and put it in the bank. Hence, money demand is low when the interest rate is high. Similarly, when interest rates are low, the cost of holding onto money is low. Hence, money demand will be high. If we assume that transaction costs are constant, then the asset motive will cause the money demand curve to slope downwards. Money demand will then be low when interest rates are high, and money demand will be high when interest rates are low. Hence, this is the shape of the money demand. When interest rates are high, low money demand, and when interest rates are low, there will be high money demand.